But the new 261 mph bug is really just about being all lit up with motor. It's about old-fashioned combustion in 16 furnaces amidships that are blown into a furious conflagration by quad-turbo fans. Push that engine button and the 8.0-liter W16 lights. Not with the ear-bending bark of an Italian supercar, Bugatti figures it is above those kinds of bad boy theatrics, but with the manly burble of a lazy 650 revolution per minute idle. To paraphrase Theodore Roosevelt, speak softly and carry a suitcase nuke, to be brutally cynical, for that's the last refuge of plebeians who cannot now and never will be able to afford a Chiron. This car is a do-over. It's a reboot of a last decade idea for reviving a slumbering auto boutique with a moonshot engineering project intended to create shock and awe. The 1001 horsepower Veyron 16 fall was the busted sound barrier, the Everest summit, the 4-minute mile. It was the car that went 1 mile per hour faster than a Peugeot P88, the fastest race car on the Mule Sound Straight, just because. The benchmarks have all been bested, the hyperbole all belabored. It seems pointless to raise the bar again with another mid-engine two-seat coupe, like enrolling Superman in a CrossFit class in the hopes of widening the gap over those speeding bullets. Viewed more charitably, the concept was perhaps not fully tapped. The Veyron may have improved greatly during its 10-year, 450-car slow drip of a production run, but its handling never rose above that.